Junction 2 is really one of a kind festival.
It probably goes up there with one of my best DJ memories.
It's amazing having a stage under the motorway like that.
Junction 2 is an electronic music festival in London, spread across 2 days in a really fantastic park called Boston Manor Park. We'd always known that we wanted to do a festival. I think, you know, if you're in the event industry putting on events, you always want to create a festival. We searched quite a long time to find the right site and Boston Manor popped up.
There are some incredible, unique spaces in London, as we all know, but I don't think that many of them are in a greenfield setting.
I loved it. I mean, I was blown away when we first saw the venue.
The main thing I remember was arriving at the bridge stage and just seeing that huge concrete sort of structure going off into infinity almost.
You got a bit of everything. It's hard to find a venue that has like an urban setting with nature around it, open field, under a bridge, in the woods. Like, it has all these different parts to it that makes it really special and interesting and something for everyone.
I looked at my directors and I was like, are you serious? Like, how come nobody has used this place before?
To be honest, for me, the main thing is the sound.
I always like a good sound system, and I always find the sound there really good because they don't really have any restrictions.
The production at Junction 2 is on another level. They really go all out to make sure everything is on point for everyone involved.
My experience with Junction 2 when I was there was the sound was a lot better than most of the, you know, the other London ones. So that just makes all the difference.
You know, we have a kind of production brief for the festival, and the flag flying at the top is solid quality.
Production is such an important role for the DJ because it just enhances the experience so much more and amplifies everything for both the dancer and the artist.
It's got this huge industrial structure and the big sound. It's just, yeah, something special.
If we're designing a stage, I'd place the sound first, then you create a stage around that. And I think some of that attention to detail allows us to get better results.
So we started at 5,000 2016 and we had 4 years of Junction 2. But within those 4 years, we managed to grow the event from just under 5,000 people to 30,000 people across 2 days.
I try and keep my team relatively small if I can, which might be like the opposite to what people expect you to say. They might want to say, oh, well, you know, we've got hundreds of people working across this. But I always think it's really good to refine your team, and I think over the years, yeah, we've just grown together. They started to do bigger shows and we started to do big shows and the festival developed. But I really do think that's a big part of the festival's success.
I think the main challenge of Junction 2 is the complexity of the site. People like to experience all the stages of Junction 2, and with that, you know, the flow in and around those different spaces on site makes crowd management quite challenging. And I think the bridge stage itself is definitely a prime example of that, because not only is under the M4 flyover, it's also an island.
So that's a challenge. We have to put in 4 temporary bridges to go across. And again, first year, you know, finding out what's the best way to do that and an affordable way to do that, you know. Which we ended up in pontoons in the end, but that was quite a challenge sussing that out.
We need to get people on and off that island safely and moving on that island safely as well. So that's probably the biggest challenge.
I did my first back-to-back with Carl Cox, and he's obviously an old hero of mine, so that was a big moment for me. And it went down really well as well. Everything kind of clicked, so it probably goes up there with one of my best DJ memories since 25 years, so.
Over the years, Junction 2 has created so many good memories. 2019 in the woods, I think it was Nicholas Lutz and Sonia Munia. Insane back to back. It kind of felt like an illegal rave, to be honest. Just like seas of people as far as you could see climbing in the trees with like a 6-point sound system there. It was just unreal.
The nature of my job means that I never see any of the moments that you probably have in mind. Like, I never see the sets, I never see the artists. You know, my memories of Junction 2 are mainly from control room, the CCTV cameras, the front door, masses of people moving about the site, because my job is to make sure that they move about the site safely and that all the systems are working.
This year's Junction 2 is going to be extra special because after 4 years, I think it'll feel really nostalgic for the people that are returning and also just super exciting for all the newbies that are going to come.
This year, every stage is actually going to be a new look.
We are back at our home at Boston Manor Park, which is very exciting. There will be completely new stage designs and new site creative.
We've had a lot of time to work on the new looks.
Maybe not start from scratch, but definitely have a fresh look at the festival and our ways and how we produce it and how we can improve it.
So this year to be playing Junction 2 is such a dream come true for me. After having worked at the festival for so many years, I feel like it's such a big achievement.
I think people can expect the typical Bayer and SARSD back to back. We've done it now for quite a few years, 5 years maybe. And it keeps evolving obviously with our music and yeah, I'm really looking forward to it.
Everyone that's been there once wants to keep going back again.
Something like Junction 2, I think, have raised the standards in the UK.
Junction 2 is a celebration of music, community, art and love, which I'm so grateful to be a part of.
I loved it and it was a great challenge, but yeah, one of the best adventures in my career, for sure.